Retool Workflows is a fast, extensible way for developers to automate scheduled jobs, custom alerts, and ETL tasks without dealing with heavy infrastructure or combing through API docs. Say that we're a vacation home rentals company, and we want to send an hourly notification to our operations team about new booking requests so that they can confirm the rental. The first thing we'll see on the canvas is our start block, where we can define how to trigger this workflow, and a query block, which will be the first step in our workflow. What I want to do first is pull all of our bookings data from our Postgres database. I'll select the resource I want, and then write SQL, like I would if I were writing a cron job. Something like, select star from bookings where status equals booked. I'll go ahead and run this individual step to validate all the logic here by clicking the play button in the block header. Here we're returning all of the bookings made on our platform. However, I only want to alert on new bookings. So what we'll need to do now is narrow this down to return new bookings made in the last hour. I'll create a new JavaScript query block to filter for new bookings made in the last hour. Because you can write custom code in every workflows block, we can import tools like the Moment library to help filter for bookings made within a certain period of time. Great, looks like we've had 60 new bookings. For each of these new bookings, I'll want to send a notification to our operations team that alerts them to confirm new bookings. In traditional programming, I might write some loop code, but in workflows, we have blocks that provide common building patterns like conditionals and for each loops built in. All you need to do is drag it onto the canvas and write any code that's unique to your exact workflow. In this loop block, I want to select our new booking Slack channel and write up a message to have triggered for each new booking, something like new booking alert value.bookingID. Now let's go ahead and deploy this version of the workflow and run it to test that everything's working. Now a couple of things will happen when you run a workflow. First, I'll see my output, in this case, these Slack notifications. I can see my run history on the left side, and logs will populate along the bottom in case I need to troubleshoot. My last step here will be to return to our start block and schedule our workflow to run every hour. I can do this either in cron syntax or more layman's terms intervals. So I'll just go ahead and set this to run every hour at 0 minutes past the hour and check that the execution cadence at the bottom is correct. So far, this is great. I've got a notification set to ping my operations team on Slack every hour to alert them of new bookings. But let's say our team has an SLA of 1 hour for bookings confirmations, and we want to move booking requests that haven't been confirmed within the SLA into an escalation queue by calling an internal API. So let's write some conditional logic. We'll leave our first query as it is, but let's add another path that will handle our unconfirmed bookings. Let's duplicate this JavaScript block and drag it down under our first path. Let's now add some JavaScript to filter for unconfirmed bookings. We'll also want to edit the time handling as we want to only escalate unconfirmed bookings when more than an hour has passed. From there, we want to post this back to our API to add the booking IDs to our escalation queue. Similarly, we want to post for each booking ID returned, so we'll use another loop block here. We'll select our REST API and then pass through the value.id parameters to make sure our operations team knows which bookings to confirm. And there we have it. What we built here today was a relatively simple workflow, but the potential for highly custom processes is endless. I can join, transform, and act on data across different data sources. I can use branch blocks to create complex if, then, else statements. I can use webhooks to alert on user behavior or trigger payloads from Salesforce to my custom CRM. I can even use and reuse functions to reference queries from my code. And I can manage all of those running jobs no matter what services they're connecting from the same platform. We can't wait to see what you build with Retool Workflows.